In Windows, you have the Program Files folder you're probably familiar with, as well as the AppData folder you might have heard of, and there's even a hidden ProgramData folder. So what's the difference, and what's the deal with the different names? Aren't programs also apps? Well, I thought I would clear it up. You see, each of these three different folders serves a very different purpose, and they have different permissions for what is required to write to them and read from them. The Program Files folder generally requires that you escalate to administrator level privileges to write to it, but any user or app can read from it without any special permissions. And usually that escalation takes the form of the UAC prompt that you get to confirm to allow the app to write to that, like when you're installing the app. Now, on the other hand, there's the AppData folder, which is gonna be specific to each user. Each user has their own AppData folder, and generally this is gonna be used for a program that you install, and then maybe multiple users will be using it. The settings for each user can go into the AppData folder. That way, for example, going back to the Program Files folder, you can have one folder that just has the program files, literally, that were installed and they don't change per version of the program. But then if the user wants to customize something, those settings go into each individual user so that it doesn't step on any other user settings. And the thing about the AppData folder is it does not require any kind of admin escalation to write to it or read to it. Any app, as long as you're logged into that user, can just read and write to it at any point, or at least for that particular user's AppData folder. You can't write to another user's AppData folder. However, it is actually possible to install a program into the AppData folder so that it only installs for that particular user. And you might have noticed when installing some programs that sometimes it'll ask you whether you want to install just for me or install for all users on the computer. And actually, behind the scenes, that is what it determines, whether you install it into the Program Files folder for all users or you install it into your own AppData folder. And that's why if you choose to install it for all users, you have to escalate and click that confirmation to be able to write to the Program Files directory, whereas you don't have to do that for AppData. Now, the third folder that I mentioned was the Program Data folder, and this is located next to the Program Files directory. And how this folder works is generally any user can write and read to it and change things inside it without having to escalate. So it's kind of like a AppData folder, but commonly shared between all users. And generally what you would use this folder for, or an app would use it for, is different files that might not be the same as when you first installed the program, like it downloads some kind of updated stuff or data, but it is going to be shared and used the same by all users. So settings probably wouldn't go in here because each user might have different settings. But for one example, I have a program called Topaz Labs where it does image upscaling and stuff, and it downloads AI models, and those are going to be the same for every user. So it just downloads them to one common program file directory, as opposed to downloading it every single time for each user. That would just be very inefficient. And the reason they have it go into the Program Data folder instead of into Program Files is so it doesn't prompt you to have to escalate as admin every single time you want to maybe update some certain thing that the app might have to update frequently. And as for why there's the different names like Program Data versus App Data and Program Data versus Program Files, what's the deal with all that? It's kind of just how it ended up being, and they just kept it like that. I don't think there's any particular distinction between files versus data and programs versus apps. I think it's just they named them differently, just have different names. So as a recap, first you have Program Files. That's just gonna be stuff that you install once and it doesn't change for that particular version of the program. Then you have AppData, which can be used to store the different settings and preferences and stuff like that for each particular user. They each have their own. Or you can also install entire apps to it just for that user. And then there's Program Data, which can store stuff that is shared among users, but changes and is not installed initially with the program. So if you were ever wondering what those different folders and stuff were for, now you know. If you enjoyed the video, you know what to do. Just lightly tap the like button. You don't want to damage it. It's very fragile. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about how I made Windows Explorer better by creating an interesting thumbnail extension. So I'll put that link right there you can click on. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos twice a week, Wednesday and Saturday, so it should be worth it. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.